Well, y'all want the breakdown of this shit? Y'all want me to speak some facts? Alright, here it go.
Hold down, man. Suitcase this, my cell phone and my charger, don't walk with a limp. Get it knocked off or missing, you gon' get it. Next time I see ass, you gon' leave airlifted.
Yo, man, welcome back to KFrogTV, man. Y'all go ahead, hit that like and subscribe button and make sure you hit that notification bell so you can see it first. Today, I figured I'd come on here and break it down to y'all a little bit about my affiliation with gangs, alright? But I'm gonna start all the way from the very beginning, from when I was younger, alright? So, for the most part, me growing up in Eastside Davie, our color, you know, as a neighborhood was, you know, we had a color which was blue, alright? 39th is we called ourselves Trey 9 because that was our street. But we ain't never been no gang, you know, we was always like a family, alright? So us growing up, the only thing that was around our way, like in my area in Broward County, was majority, you know, Crips and GDs. When it came to us, you know, our color being blue, which is the same as what Crips were, you know, we had certain ones that we actually got into it with behind this whole situation, like ones that would try to press us, you know, about the color blue or whatever. And we used to tell them, like, look, shit, it is what it is. Boy, that's both our colors then, you feel me? We just repped our neighborhood. You get what I'm saying? Now that I'm older, my neighborhood don't really stand by that color shit no more. You know, we're just Eastside Davie boys. But we still be on Trey 9, which is 39th. That's Marathon Block. All the times y'all heard me say something about Marathon Block, pull up, you know what I'm saying, where you at, blah, blah, blah. Boy, I be on Eastside Marathon Block. That is 39th. That's why we say Trey 9. Now, when I was real young, like 13, 14 years old, before I landed in the juvenile program for a couple years, I ended up growing up with older cats. The cats that I ended up growing up with, two of them were, you know, Crips. One was a Midnight and another one was Insane or something like that. Those were, I hung out with the older crowd. They were old enough to get the liquor bottles for us when I was only 13, 14 years old. Now, me growing up at the same time as us repping our neighborhood, these Crip people who we knew at the time, you know, they was really, you know, they was out there in the middle of that lifestyle with that gang shit. They had enemies and rivalries and, you know, they actually had a lot of beef going on to where people were actually scared to say that they were cool with them certain individuals. You feel me? Not one time have I repped anything else other than Eastside Davie. All right. Now, anytime that I was affiliated with a different organization was strictly business. You know, like we was either, you know, going through them for something, you know, making money, you know, however it was. I'm not going to put that all out here. Like, I'm the type of person that has a good face card with any organization that you could think of. Okay. So, which that's 90% better than not having a face card with those gangs. You get what I'm saying? So, like, we would actually go and get into it and beat up, you know, Crips and things like that. You know, they felt some type of way about my neighborhood being blue, all right? But like I said, I grew up like this, all right? And the three main reasons that I would never, ever be a gang member, I'm going to tell you right now. One, I already stand for something. That's Eastside Davie boy, all right? A lot of people that our gang members, you see how proud they are to say, oh, nigga, I bang, I do this, I do that, because they actually get to be a part of something. They're standing for something that they actually get to be a part of. I already stand for something, and I'm trying to put my hood, my neighborhood on the map by me. You get what I'm saying? I'm not trying to push another movement that's already been formed and already got a name for itself, okay? And I've been doing a pretty damn good job putting Davie on the map. You see what I'm saying? So, me, I feel, you know, good and confident and everything when I say I ain't affiliated. You know, like, I'm the opposite of how some gang members are. They feel like, because they stand for something, they feel like they feel good and confident when they say, yeah, man, I bang, boy, I'm this, I'm da-da-da, or whatever it is. You know, me, I'm the opposite. I feel good and confident when I let them know I'm unaffiliated. You feel me? Because I've came across so many different organizations and had so many people mention, damn, boy, you ready to come home, bro? All this to where I know the gang shit, you get what I'm saying? Like, and I feel good to know that I didn't break and become one, all right? Now, another reason I want to become a gang member is, like I said, I know so many different ones from different sets and organizations, and it's been like that since I was little. So I would never want anyone to think that I was siding with someone else, or that the person I sided with was better than their organization, or anything like that. So I would feel like I'm betraying someone. You get what I'm saying? If I came home to this gang, I feel like I'm betraying him and him who are in that gang, or vice versa. You see what I'm saying? I would never want anyone to feel that way, because I fought with everybody the same amount. Everybody got the same exact opportunity and the same amount of love from KFROG. It doesn't matter what gang you in, what organization, what you stand for. If you're a solid person and you carry yourself and you real and we click and it is what it is, then I'm rocking with you. You're my dog. You feel me? So that's another reason I want to join the gang, because I don't want to feel like I'm letting someone else down by picking someone else. Feel me? But the main reason that I would never become a gang member, okay, is my dad, all right? And the reason I say that is my dad was an East Side Davy boy like me before I was even born. When I came into this shit, my dad had blue. Blue was what my dad wore and everything like that. So did all the old school dudes that grew up down in my neighborhood and everything like that. They all wore blue. It was like I just grew up into that lifestyle. You see what I'm saying? Now, it came to the point to where me and my dogs were pushing it extremely hard, though. We were trying to really, really put it on the map. So, like, we didn't care what gang you was in. We banged on gang members. To us, we banged, but us banging wasn't a gang. It was just we banged, which means whoever want it can get it. If you didn't like us, you can get it. You can line that shit up. We didn't care if your color was blue, just like the color of my neighborhood. We didn't care if it was red, black, gold, you know, baby blue, green, orange, purple. We didn't care what the color was. If you didn't fuck with Davey or had problems with someone or disrespected us, we'd line that shit up with you. That's why I always say I bang on gang members, because I don't care that someone's a gang member. I've been fighting them my whole life, okay? Now, I know a couple people trying to say, oh, KFROG was a crip. KFROG was, man, I ain't never been in no gang, okay? And I'm gonna say it like this. If I was ever affiliated before this, that set can suck it on soft, all right? That's how I feel. Any set that I was with, any set that I was in, or any gang that I was in, can suck it on soft, okay? Now, I could say that because I wasn't in no other set, no gang or anything like that. You feel what I'm saying? So no one should get offended by me saying that. You get what I'm saying? That's why I could say that. You feel me? But you got people out there that want to make little videos and bullshit and run their mouth talking about, oh, he was repping Trey Nine Gangsters, which was a Crips. No, that's my block. Y'all can look it up. Marathon Block, 39th. You feel me? On the back of my new mixtape I just dropped, I put a picture of the street sign there. Marathon Block is 39. We called ourselves Trey Nine. Still do to this day. Meet me on Trey Nine, bro. That's my hood. I know I ain't just the only one. I know a lot of people grew up with their little neighborhood, you know, repping their streets and shit like that. You feel me? But I guess because I didn't turn into a gang member down the line and become a gang member, some people look at it like I'm wrong. I mean, to me, I ain't, because I still want to change shit. I'm not repping nothing but my neighborhood. I'm gonna push my neighborhood, and that's what it is. I got my state tatted on me. I got my county tatted on me. I got my city tatted on me. I got my street tatted on me. I got it all to where I would never stand for anything other than Eastside Davy. And anyone who knows me personally knows this. That's why I say I am my team and I'm unaffiliated. I just had a face card with all the different gang, unaffiliated, but heavy affiliated, all right? And any organization that I clicked with or ended up being affiliated with some type of way, it all strictly was business. It never led to anything. It was all strictly business. And then, you know, in the middle of business, you end up getting friendships and you end up, you know, being cool. And then now you're going to rock with your homeboy. You're going back with your dog. It is what it is. You feel me? Like, for instance, when I was at Calhoun, all the Zoes were my dogs. That's who I was in the dorm with, a bunch of Zoes, ZMF from down south. They were like, boy, that white boy from Lauderdale, boy, he the boy, you already know, boy. I put on, gritted a couple times, they all fucked with me. They're like, boy, that's home team. You feel me? Ended up fighting a Chico, ended up fighting some other dudes from Gainesville, fought someone from Indian Town, a different gangs. And then after all that happened, you know, I ended up landing at Charlotte. When I landed at Charlotte, I ended up getting cool with the Kings, you know, the Chicos, the Spanish ones, you feel me? They ended up being my dogs, but the Zos, they're all fucked with me. All the GDs, all the Crips, all the Blood, everyone, they all fucked with me. I was just one of them persons that it doesn't matter who you are or what gang you were in. If I feel like you disrespected me, I'm going to press that shit and I'm going to test it, because I'd rather lose and get beat up than to let something sit on my mind and feel like, dog, I feel like he played me, bro. I feel like he tried me. You see what I'm saying? And that's just how it was. But I have never been in a gang. That's exactly why I dropped my merch called Unaffiliated. Never been in no gang. Just like it's wrong for someone to claim a gang when they're not in it, how they're false claiming, you know, that is wrong. You know, people get wet up, flipped, ate, X'd out, do all this different shit happens to them when they false claim something they are not, right? I feel like it should be wrong for someone else to false claim someone. You know what I'm saying? Like someone saying, oh, I'm a Crip. KFROG is a Crip. That's bullshit. I feel like the people who's pushing that should be flipped, because you shouldn't be able to say another man is a part of an organization when he is not part of an organization. He can get in trouble for saying it. Why can't the others get in trouble for saying it for him or about him? You know what I'm saying? Trying to send a message. And the reason that I feel like people are trying to do that is because they want me to come out of pocket about a gang. They want me to talk disrespectful about a gang. You feel me? Like, man, fuck that. F such and such, you know? Like, oh, boy, I ain't never been one of them. Fuck them. You just, like, they want me to come out of pocket so that way any beef, it leads bigger than it being just the individuals. It leads to the beef with a nation. You feel me? Even if it ain't a nation they're in. Like, the person saying it's not in the same nation. They want me to come out of pocket and be like, man, you got me fucked up. I ain't never been one of them, man. Fuck them. Da-da-da-da. That's what they want me to do. So that way, I have an organization on my back now. But I would never come out of pocket towards an organization, because I have so many different people I know that are parts of all these different organizations. And I would never disrespect any one of my dogs or their organization, you feel me? On the strength of my dog. Be scared, you know, to have beef with someone one-on-one. So they wanna try to, they think they know how to play chess and not checkers, when really the whole time they're playing checkers, you feel me? They try to get it to where they bring other people into the beef. So like right now, if I were to say, man, fuck y'all, da da da, then that, instead that's me bringing a whole nother entourage into the middle of a beef, you feel me? I ain't never been in no gang. My neighborhood growing up, Eastside Davy, Trey 9, which is 39th, my street. I'm gonna rep my neighborhood to the day I'm gone. I am not ashamed of where I came from or none of that. My dad repped that shit. The people before him repped that shit. And I'm gonna keep repping that shit. I will never rep anything else. I ain't never been a part of nothing else, but I've been affiliated with several gangs because, like I said, my face card, I'm cool with different people. You know what I'm saying? And I'm pretty sure 90% of white boys, you know, would rather not be affiliated but have the face card with the gangs than to not have the face card, okay? Because when you have the face card, that shit, it helps you out in situations, especially in prison. If you get in an altercation with someone and you want a one-on-one with them, since you got a face card, boy, his head gonna give you that. They gonna stamp that, and they gonna let you get your one-on-one. They gonna make sure you don't get jumped or stabbed when you ain't looking. You see what I'm saying? And it makes it to where you could be like, man, hey, man, they just knocked my jack off, bro. Let me get that one right there, bro. And I got you on tomorrow or 3 days from now. I'll bring the money. I'll get the money sent in. Boom. They're going to trust you with $600 worth of something. Or you can, you know, vice versa. You could bless them. You know, you trust them too. So it, like, it goes a long way. I'd rather be someone that has face with different gangs than someone that didn't. Because it tends to get some gang members mad that this white boy has just as enough face and pool and basically a spot to where I'm cool with everyone just as much as they do, but they are affiliated. They can get a violation for shit like that. They can literally get a V for certain things. I can't. You know what I'm saying? Like the littlest things. Like some nations have it to where it's mandatory rec at prison. In prison, mandatory rec, where they gotta go to rec anytime the doors open, it's rec call, they gotta go out there. Feel me? I don't gotta do that because I'm not affiliated. You know what I'm saying? Or, oh, don't do this, bro. You don't go do that, bro. You do that, you're gonna get a V. Shit, I can go do it, my nigga. I got you. Boom, they can't V me. I'm not a gang member. And go do it for your homeboy. It definitely helps you out, you know, being cool with gang members than it wouldn't. You know what I'm saying? Like, because by you having that face card, it's just to where you're good anywhere you go. You get what I'm saying? And it ain't gonna just happen to you. It's gonna be spoke on amongst people, whether you know it or not. It ain't gonna just, oh, they gonna just come wet you. No, they're gonna have to speak to someone before it happens. That's another good thing about being cool with different gang members. You feel me? But I just wanted to break that shit down and let y'all know it ain't ever been nothing but strictly business with me and all the organizations. That's why I salute all the organizations and I don't pick sides. You feel me? But I have homeboys that, you know, like might be this gang and this gang, and then now their gangs are going to beef. You feel me? Me, I'll stay out of it. But if one of their brothers that I'm not cool with jump on one of my dogs, then I'll jump on him. You see, that's just how I've always been. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, when I was younger growing up, my neighborhood was the color blue. You feel me? And that's what it is. And I ain't ashamed of it, because I know it ain't no Crip shit. Like I used to tell them Crips, though. They used to say, oh, that's our color. I used to say, well, it's both our colors then, because we ain't finna change our colors. You tripping. Boy, the people before me used to wear this color. And you gonna sit here? You know, it was really a color movement in my neighborhood, for my street, for my area, you know? And that's what, you know, that's how it was. And that's what, like, you know, that's what sculpted me into who I am today. You feel me? Is that. But as we got older, we don't really follow the color thing, you know? And our rivalries, like who we were beefing with, Davey, we used to beef with Hollywood, you know, we used to beef with Crips, GDs, you know, shit like that. Everything that was around us, we didn't care. We was our own shit. And now it's to the point to where Davey is beefing amongst each other between the east side and the west side. That's why I always say east side. When I say that, I'm not saying the East Coast over the West Coast. Like, I'm not saying East Side and speaking for the East Coast. I'm speaking for East Side Davey, because Davey was like this. Now we done split into two different neighborhoods. And that's still how it is to this day. Got a song on my new mixtape called Davey Freestyle. And even in there, I say I rep blue so hard, affiliate with the Crips. And I do bang, bitch. Let it be known. Ain't on that shit gangbanging, though, nigga, I'm grown. I make it known, like, yeah, I ain't scared to let y'all know I'm cool with some of these Crips that are out here. You feel me? I ain't scared to let y'all know that. Because a lot of people were scared to let people know that back then. Because that's who everyone wanted around my way, was the Crips. You see what I'm saying? That's who had all the pressure. And like I said, I was 13 and 14 years old. And these dudes were 21, 22 years old. You see what I'm saying? And I got in two incidents with them on the Fort Lauderdale Beach when I was real young. We was walking down the strip, and one of the dudes that I was walking with, I was a JIT, skipping school and everything. I was supposed to be in school in the morning. Instead, I'm pulling an all-nighter on the beach. You feel me? I was in an alternative school and didn't even go to school. And we walking down the beach. And the person I'm with or whatever, he ends up getting an altercation or whatever about his bandana. He had a bandana. And someone was like, oh, I like your bandana or whatever. And then he turned around and was like, oh, take it out of my pocket then. And then a big conflict happened and everything like that. And it was the first time that I ever seen, you know, people get busted at. And I was there, and I was young. I was a JIT. You feel me? Like, people had pressure with them. Me, I was on some fuck that. I ain't scared to say I'm cool with these people, because due to my color of my neighborhood, blue, someone may mistake me for one of them anyways. People are gonna see us wearing blue or whatever and think that we're a Crip and come jump out on us, right? You feel me? So like, in my neighborhood, we wasn't ashamed. That was repping my neighborhood. And to this day, I rep Eastside Davey. You feel me? To this day, I'm not gonna change how I was brought up. You feel me? And I would never join no gang, ever. Doesn't matter how many cool homeboys I got from what organization. It doesn't matter if 10 of them want me on that side, 10 of them want me on this side, 15 want me over here, 13 of them want me over here. I would never join, because I'm an Eastside Davey boy. And everywhere I went, people told me, boy, I ain't never heard of Davey boy. You feel me? Till I met Frog, da da da. Now when they hear of it, first thing they ask, you know someone named KFROG? See, I'm gonna put on for my hood, because that's what my dad stood for. And that's how I was brought into this world. You see what I'm saying? Shit, I had a blue, my Crown Vic before it got all shot up, my Crown Vic was black. My dad took my Crown Vic for my birthday and went with his blue bandana. My dad was like, I wanted this color. And for my birthday, he got my car painted for me. It didn't have the design of the bandana or whatever, but it was the navy blue, my bubble, my Crown Vic. He went while I was in the county jail, matter of fact. I was in the county jail, sitting in the county jail doing 90-day sentence or whatever, on a violation. I violated, but they gave me 90 days followed by reinstatement. So out of 90, you do like 60 and some change. My birthday was coming up. My old boy took my car and went and had it, got it painted. And when I got out, my shit was dark blue. You know, that was just the color of our neighborhood. You get what I'm saying? And shit, I ain't ashamed of it at all. And it isn't like, oh, because this person likes that color, or this person claims that color, bro, that's who they trying to be like. Man, it ain't nothing like that. Because I done seen so many different signs that people have in different places. Might throw a B up because for Bloods, but then they might throw it up because they're from Boynton Beach. Or you never know what it is. People throw their sets. It's not the same everywhere. When we're throwing our threes up like this or whatever, they were saying, oh boy, you throwing up blood, you throwing bees up and all that. You see, like, it's totally different. You don't know what a person is claiming something for. You don't know what a person's throwing something up for. People were putting on for Davey Boys before I was even thought of. And I just got brought into it and I kept it moving. That's what it is. You feel me? So I figured I'd do this little video real quick, break it down to y'all about my affiliation with gangs. Okay, like I said, it's always been strictly business. Then you end up, you know, being cool with certain ones. It makes everyone fuck with you when you're a solid individual. I don't care what gang someone is, what race you are, what you stand for. I don't care about none of that. If you live in a 100 and a straight solid life and you ain't on no fuck shit or you're not living foul or nothing like that, frog fuck with you, you feel me? I don't care, though, about someone being affiliated, you feel me? It doesn't matter to me what color you rep. If you disrespect me, or if you've disrespected me in the past before, you already know that I'ma get in there with you, and I'ma make you show me. You feel me? It doesn't matter if you repped blue, black, green, purple, orange, yellow, none of that. I will easily put my hands on someone just as quick. It doesn't matter what color they rep. My neighborhood, we grew up repping blue. That was the color of my hood. But we done beat up Crips too before. You see what I'm saying? Like, over some bullshit. You feel me? But at the same time, this video is just I want to throw it out there about my affiliations with gangs, okay? And that's why I made this video, to let y'all know I ain't never been no gang member. I ain't never rep shit other than Eastside Davey. My neighborhood is and block is still Trey 9. Everyone already knows that. Feel me? People got that shit tatted in my hood. Trey 9, you feel me? And that's what it is. You get what I'm saying? But don't get me wrong. Now, you may have people on the West Coast that might have a Trey 9 something, or somewhere else is Trey 9 something. That don't mean that we're repping they shit. Hell no, we repping what we stand for. You get what I'm saying? Now, I could see if someone had, like, if they were like, oh, deuce deuces. Oh, we deuce deuces. You feel me? But never been nowhere around deuce deuce or anything that has to relate to deuce deuce or anything like that. Then it looks like, yeah, they trying to false claim and run with some shit. But man, my block is Trey 9. You feel me? Literally. And everyone knows that. Marathon block is Trey 9. It's on the back of my new mixtape I just dropped. If you go look at my community section, the same mixtape that I'm about to send around the world and give away for free after I do the bracelet giveaway. The next one's going to be the CDs. When I do that, you're going to see on the back of there my exact street, Trey 9. That is my block. And instead of us saying 39th, you know, we just figured Trey 9, hey, meet me on Trey 9. And that's just how it turned into Trey 9. But I got a reason to say that, because that's my block. You feel what I'm saying? So I got people hitting me up, oh, you used to be a Crip, this and that, this and that. Man, I ain't never been that, bro. I ain't never been that, bro. But I've been affiliated with them, just like I've been affiliated with Kings, GDs, Bloods, Cutthroats, ZMF, all of them. I've been affiliated with all of them. You feel me? There's no way around it. There is no way you're going to say you haven't. If you live the lifestyle I lived. See what I'm saying? When one door closes, 10 others open. So you're gonna find yourself around more and more people who are affiliated, especially coming up down south. When you go to our county jail, shit, you get put in a dorm, you know what I'm saying? It's fucking 80% of them people in that damn dorm gonna be gangbanging. Probably more than that, you know? It's just different. And then when you go to prison down here, it's the same way, and we're all thrown in there together. You see what I'm saying? So I just wanted to come on here and break it down to y'all and let y'all know how my affiliation is with gangs. And I salute to all the gang members, even though I say it, you know, I bang on gang members, which I do. I fight gang members and all. I don't care if they gang bang, but I still salute, because they all have their own causes and they have their own shit they believe in, their own structures. Everything they got going on is on them. But me, I'm more on trying to make my own, you see, not make my own Crip set. I'm not trying to make my own GD set. I'm trying to make Davey be worldwide known. I'm trying to put on for my neighborhood. I want to put on what made me. See what I'm saying? That's what I want to do. I want to make what made me known. And so far, I've been doing good with it. You know, and I'm going to continue to keep pushing that shit, because I know that my old boy loved it also. You get what I'm saying? My old boy was in my neighborhood. He grew up in my neighborhood when it was dirt roads. That's how long, back when there was dirt roads in the neighborhood, when it was one-way lanes, one way this way, one way this way. When I grew up, there was three this way, three this way. It was totally different back then when you know what I'm saying? Back when, you know, my old boy was coming up and all the other old timers was coming up. And I would never, you know, go against that. I would never go against that. Even though my dad ain't here, even if he was here, I would never go against that and become a gang member to anything else, because I strictly stand for Eastside TV. The whole world knows it. You get what I'm saying? And that's what it is, man. But I appreciate y'all watching this video. Right now, it is 7 o'clock in the morning. You know, I just decided I'd come out here and make this little video for y'all real quick. Let y'all know the bracelet giveaway is going to be happening pretty soon. I'm almost at 800 followers on the gaming channel. If y'all ain't go subscribe yet, it's Game Punisher. I posted it in my community a couple days ago. As soon as I hit 1,000 subscribers on the game channel, I'm starting a giveaway. I got all the envelopes with the postage. I got the bracelet. I got everything ready. Next, I'm going to release the email, and then I'm just going to start sending the bracelets out, okay? But I'm waiting until I get 1,000 subscribers on the gaming channel. Like I said, I'm at almost 800. I think I'm at like 780-something. I need like 220 more. Once I hit 1,000 subscribers, I'm going to send these bracelets out, okay? I haven't had them too long. It's about time to send them all out. But anyways, I appreciate y'all tuning in, watching this video. And like I said, I ain't got nothing against no gang members, no different organizations. I salute to all that shit. I salute to all the causes, you feel me? But that shit just ain't for me, okay? Me, I'm an Eastside Davey boy. That's what I rep. That's how I was brought up. And that's how I'm going to go down. You feel me? Just like that. But you already know, growing up in my hood, boy, I grew up repping Trey 9, boy, which is my motherfucking block. All right? But anyways, I'll see y'all next time. Frog.